Many people have asked me about my awakening experience, and I've tried to keep a low profile, but having looked at many YouTube videos, I noticed that there's a lack of understanding in some of them in terms of helping you to understand what you are, why you're here, and the purpose of your life, and what this planet Earth is all about. So let me begin by sharing a little background. There's a lot of background. I'm going to show you something now. This book, The Awakening Process, rather big. It's like a telephone directory. I think it's about 600 pages, 500 or 600 pages. It contains 8 courses, and I'm giving this to you free of charge. But in the book, there's a full biography about my life, because people keep asking me about it. So I won't take up too much time now about it. I'll get straight to what actually happened to me, my awakening experience. First of all, I came to a point of spiritual seeking. I was actually involved with a Buddhist organization, and a schism occurred, a split, where I was asked to choose between practicing with the priests or practicing with the lay society. Well, to me, this didn't make any sense, because I see the whole thing as one. So it gave me a chance to leave and investigate on my own what is this thing called enlightenment, because I've had a good life, but I haven't had this experience. So what I did was I gave up, I said, everything I've learned in Buddhism, in spirituality, hasn't got me there. It's helped tremendously in my life, but I can't say I know anything's for real. There's something more than this. And so what I did was I said, I know nothing. I give up. I surrendered in that sense, and saying, I'm an emptiness, and I really meant it from my heart. I really, really meant it. There must be more. I want to know what that is. So I wanted to know what the Buddha had experienced, this enlightenment experience. And I also wanted to know what Christ had experienced, this I am one with God. I am the Son of God, so everybody has told us. I am God, but I've incarnated as a man, and I'm here. So I wanted to know what this God is. The Buddha says this can only be shared between Buddhas. So unless you're a Buddha, an enlightened Buddha, how are you ever going to know as a human being? So anyway, that was my motivation. That was my goal. And so what I've got in the Buddhist organization, there's 2 books called the Lotus Sutra. And in this book, the Buddha says, this is my highest teaching, and it will lead you to enlightenment. So I wanted to know what was in the book. So I got 2 copies of the book, shut myself away in my flat and said, I'm not coming out apart from shopping for food and things. I'm not going to go anywhere until I've had this experience. A madman. I turned into a mad person. You could say, I went to the cave in the Himalayas. No, I went in my flat. So if you had a camera on the wall, it would have made great television and YouTube and social media viewing, because he's that. What's he doing today? Look at him. Look at what he's doing. So what I did was crazy. I'm not asking you to do that, and you don't need to do it. But I had to find out for myself. And that you have to do the same. So I went through, got 2 copies of the book, one from the sect that I belonged to, which I've now left, and another one from an opposing sect. The reason for that was because I didn't trust anything anymore, and I wanted to make sure nobody adopted the teachings, like they've done with the Bible and the Quran. Man has come along and added pretty awful bits in it, actually, but the actual core teachings of the Bible and the Quran are true. They're beautiful. So there I was. I took down all my paraphernalia, a scroll that I used to chant to called Gahons, and took it down and said, and chanted and chanted, reading the chapter, each chapter. They all agreed nothing had been really doctored. It was true. And then because I was chanting for hours until I had self-realization over each chapter, and I was so charged up with the chanting, and I got the wisdom, I knew, yes, this is, I understand this is true. Yes, we are eternal. Yes. Yes, these are the workings of life. This is the phenomena. So I got that. And of course I was buzzing because I've been chanting for days. And then I did something else. I said, well, that's fine from the Buddhist point of view, from the Buddha. I get the wisdom. I understand that. I've realized it. I've self-realized it. And then I did something else. I sent as much love as I could to this invisible God, you know, this God that everybody's talking about in many religions. So I was sending this love out. I love you, God. I love everything. I saw everything as God. In my flat, I was pick up a cushion. I love you, God. Complete mad person. But I had to have this emotion, this depth of emotion and passion, and saying, I know nothing, I'm an empty book, I love you, God, where are you, manifest for me. And I was just sat there, and then all of a sudden I attracted something from the Ascendant Master Realm, or God, I don't know, who can say what it is, but I attracted something, and all of a sudden I was just sat on the bed, just relaxed, sent out my love, and all of a sudden it was like sitting underneath Niagara Falls of love. It came into me, went down inside me, oh my goodness, right to my base chakra, my energy center at my base. And it was like an egg timer. These things are, there's no time. So the experiences, when you have these sort of mystical experiences, it might only be a short time, but it appears a long time, because time doesn't exist when you have this experience. You have it for as long as you need to understand it. So filling me up, it was like going up in a lift. And I was wondering what was going on. It was beautiful. This love filling me up, filling me up, filling me up, lifting me up, raising me up. And then here, I came face to face, not a person, but a divine being. I can't explain it in terms of direct connection through this third eye. There was a beautiful exchange happening. The questioner in my personal mind, the one that asks the questions, the personal mind, the seeker, had disappeared, because there was so much peace and contentment. I was so contented, I was blissed out. I didn't need to know anything. There was nothing left to know, because I was experiencing it, this ocean of love, infinite ocean of love. And it's not a love like when you have a girlfriend or a boyfriend and my darling or my child or my pet, whatever it is that you love, that human love, oh no, it's much greater. It's a much bigger love. You have to experience it to know. And this is the love of God, I suppose. So then what happened? I was first of all told, this is where you're coming, you know, sort of congratulations, you've made it. This is where you're coming when you leave the body. So that pathway was opened to Ascendant Master Realm. I saw another entrance, or I came to the end of what a person in a body can experience. And it was like life continues in a divine form, in a non-physical form. And the entry to that place is awakening to this ocean of love and pure knowingness. You know everything. You know everything without being intrusive, without having to, it arises in you. Knowingness just arises. This happened. Then I was shown, I then saw, so I was one opposite with this divine true being inside of me, and I was seeing that there was no desires in me whatsoever, except one desire was left in me, was to share this with the world. I wanted to come back and share it with mankind, this ocean of love, this presence of God. And most incredible. I knew it could transform mankind. If mankind could access it, I could access it. I was blessed. So what to do with it? So then I was shown, this is very interesting, because I was shown, I could see my body shrinking down, and everybody's body in a physical form, it was like a tiny speck of grain of sand, tiniest little speck connected to all of life on planet Earth. And that was my body, my physical body. I wasn't in it. That was it. Part of like an organic, subject to all the scientific laws of life. But this tiny little thing made up the whole planet Earth with everybody else, every living being. And then I was shown there's one mind, which is very interesting. And this mind had two gravitational poles. It's a bit like planet Earth. It's a bit like the North and South Pole. One pole pulled a human being's mind into a gross, low-level consciousness, a dark place with hardly any light. Of course, the light is there, but you can't see it. You're like in a cave. And we know this when people are suffering and trouble on Earth. That's the place, low consciousness, where the soul is existing. Now, the soul is what I was, what I am, inside this body. So the body becomes the vehicle for your soul. And the soul is connected to God, the divine light. And your objective is to evolve to the light, to the love, to what I've experienced. Because when you die, depending on how you've lived your life, you will have evolved towards the light or devolved towards this gross consciousness. They could say heaven and hell, but it's not like that. It's not as mindy, human mind interpretation is incorrect. There's nothing wrong at all in life. There's only consequences. Consequences for whatever you do, and through that you will learn. If you make the wrong choices, you will suffer because it will come back in your life. There's a strict law of cause and effect working on planet Earth. And you create your own life and then live in it and experience your own creation. So create something beautiful and then you'll live in a beautiful life and your soul will evolve. Now the other thing I saw, so there's this gross potential of the mind. There's one mind, and everybody's mind inside of me, everything was inside of me. This was phenomenal. Everything on planet Earth was inside of me. So everybody's mind is connected to my mind through telepathy, through attention, putting your attention on someone. You will activate, ring their telephone inside their mind. They would, people say, oh, I knew you were going to phone. I was thinking about you. Well, they put their attention on you and you received it. This is how this works. So all of these minds are contained in one mind. Now, the other end of the spectrum is the divine light, the Godhead of life. So we are working towards unconditional love. So that is where we need to raise our consciousness of our soul being to actually get to that place, to transcend, to go through into the realm of God, what we know as God. Now, in that realm, I can't tell you what goes on. I cannot tell you, except there's eternal life. That's all I can tell you, because I hadn't been there. But I've got to a place beyond what most people could ever, ever experience. So this coming back then down into this world. So I was outside this planet Earth. It's like an orb. I was outside of it and I saw we're all contained like in a bubble in one spiritual orb called planet Earth. And we're part of it. And we evolve and reincarnate. Yes, we reincarnate and go round and round the cycle. And you choose your incarnation. It's like choosing the vehicle. You can see before you're born your parents. And you can see the life, because it's destiny, if you like. It starts here, it ends there, birth, death, and along the way, you'll meet these people, have these experiences, and you'll go, oh yeah, that's a good vehicle to go in, that person there. I think I'll be born into that one, and then I'll have these challenges, these opportunities to evolve my soul. And that's the purpose of it all. So mankind has really, really got it wrong. They've got it wrong. Because they're focused on the outer world. And if you only focus on the outer world, survival, self-gain, materialism, it's all very nice, but it's at the expense of everything else. And you might have to do things that actually devolve your soul. And then after you've died, you'll go, oh my God, oh no, look what I've done. So don't make that mistake. I'm giving you an opportunity now. One of the things that happened to me after I had the experience, I went, gosh, oh my God, it's happened. So then I just tested it. My beloved, the presence emerged. It's like opened the blinds of the window. Pure light was shining from me. In fact, I've met many spiritual gurus along the way, and they say, what's happened to you? You're full of divine light. You're full of divine light. I've met other people that have said, oh my God, there's just love in every one of your chakras. It's oozing out of you. Now, one of the things I did after I had this experience was to know I wanted to test it. I'm always like this. I've got I want to prove it. I want to make sure it's real and not just my fantasy, because I've wanted it. So I got some people together, and three people came around and said, I'm going to let the presence out. I want you to experience, see what happens, and see if it's real or not. So they all willingly came around to my flat, I think, or wherever we were. I can't remember even where we were. But anyway, we got together. I let out the presence. One lady started shaking. So I went over to her and said, if it's too strong, you can leave. I can't stop the presence now, it's coming through. And she said, no, no, no. I said, well, just lie down, lie down. Her body was shaking. And I guided her through the resistance and the thing, and she then went into ecstatic state of love. The love was so beautiful, and so that was proof for her. There was another lady sat in the corner of the room, never spoke, never said anything, but upon leaving, when it was over, upon leaving, she said, "I've been very, very ill." I said, "Yeah." She said, "I've had healing sessions. I've been to doctors. I can't get well. But when this experience came, I was wrapped. The whole of my being was cocooned in a body of healing." And she reported afterwards she was completely healed. That's the power of the presence. It was like a miracle out of the Bible. It's incredible. So there was one other lady who was, I want to know, tell me, what's this, what's that, wanting to know, bombarding me with questions. So we took one particular seeking question, and as soon as she asked it, instantly, I was sat there doing nothing. I instantly knew the presence went through my life, brought up the answer. I knew exactly the answer, no thinking involved, because pure emptiness in my mind. And I thought to myself, how on earth can I share the answer with this lady? Because it's from my life experience. Anyway, I shared it, and she said, "That's very interesting." Now, her mind was going to ask another question, but the presence fixed her mind so it couldn't move, the thinking, questioning mind. And so she was fixed, and then the presence went through her life experience. She had a knowingness arise, and she said, "Well, it's very interesting what you said, but I see it like this." And then she answered, and I said, "That's perfect. That's exactly the enlightened answer to your question." So what does this show? It shows that you don't have to be super intelligent to have divine wisdom, the knowledge of God. You just have to have a stillness of mind, an emptiness within inside, and of course the presence held her mind there. Through me, the presence could emerge, divine presence, and she was fixed, so she couldn't move and knew the answer. So I had proof then that this was it. So what I did after that, I thought, Robert, you know, oh, this is fantastic. I'm going to go and share it with the world now. This is it. And they can just have the presence, and the people will get healed. People will go into love. People will know whatever, get the answers to all their questions. Fantastic. So this is my, if I go, this is what I'm going to do. I've made it. I'm all right. And I'm going to help everybody else. It didn't work out like that. The first thing I did was I went out and thought, oh, I was so full of energy, so full of joy. I wanted to go dancing. I wanted to dance. It's some years back now. So in the mid-90s. So I went to a local dance near me. So I went out to give it some dancing because I was just so full of energy and joy. And I thought, well, I know what I'll do. I'll let the presence out and everybody will have a great time. I let the presence out. It was like the parting of the waves. The room started to split into two groups of people. And on my left, I just got in the door. On my left was mostly groups of men. And on my right, mostly groups of ladies. The ladies were going all gooey, because they could feel the love presence, because ladies have a greater connection with love than most men. So you ladies are very fortunate in that way. The men were getting angry. They were getting angry because what actually happened? I thought, what's going on here? I was getting concerned. There's one side, these ladies all feeling the love and sort of this other side, there's this angriness coming out of this men, and they were trying to find out where this disturbance coming from that was disturbing their mind and disturbing their life. And they were getting very angry. They wanted it to stop. So I immediately stopped the presence, went outside, thought, I can't let the presence out. What is going on? So my divine master, I had an inner master then, enlightened being from the ascendant master realm, said, you can't do that. I said, why not? It's too strong. It's too strong a presence. It transforms people too quickly. They have to evolve themselves. So I said, okay, well, if I can't do that, I'll have to open an ashram and put warning signs outside. Only leave your mind outside. Only come in and feel the presence if you want to transform into divine love. So then the master said, no, there's others here doing that now. This is not your path. It's not your incarnation. You're not here to do that. So I said, well, I said, you've been a guru and had an ashram in a past life. You've done it all before. So what am I to do? You're here to support those that are in the front line, being gurus. They're just playing a role. You're here to support them and provide teachings for mankind. So this is what's happened. And well, if I can't, so I started giving people healing sessions. And again, they were saying, stop, stop, stop. It's too strong. It's too strong. And I just let some time go by. I was okay. But I had this sense of mission of to help mankind because I was free. So anyway, the bottom line of it is that I started an organisation. I was told by the divine that I have to learn Reiki healing. I said, but I can heal, but it's too strong. The Reiki healing, I was told, is for a purpose. This book, by the way, don't worry, I'm not trying to sell it to you. I'm giving it to you. If you go to my website, you can download this free. It's got 8 modules in it. It's got all the Reiki healing modules, all fully colour. It's got all about the chakras, chakra relationships. It's all got about how the mind works. It'll teach you spiritual laws of life. Let me have a look. I'll find something for you. There we are. There's a very interesting little bit there which will teach you. There's a triangle called persecutor, rescuer and victim. It's very interesting to learn this. Once you've learned it, it can help you as a human being evolve. So it teaches you everything. There we are. I was then asked to create a sacred mantra back to yoga CD. Because as many people, beautiful people, David Pramal, Sanatan Kaur, they do these beautiful yogic mantras. And they're beautiful to listen to and they will transform you. But what I was asked to do was to take these mantras, put them in a certain order and record them so that you can chant with them, removing all the commercial no harmonies, all the commercial added lines like, oh my beloved, I love you, I want to find you again, all these things, mind, where this is pure heart. And the mantras would awaken the different chakras and will evolve your soul. So your soul would gain more light and you were raising consciousness. Getting very close then, you'll get very close by just chanting these mantras. So just recently, 10 years later, after creating the divine message with you, which I have given free in this book, there's all the courses, there's free, you can do them all free. Anyway, what happened next was this. The Ascendant Masters came 10 years later and I was informed that the practice that was running the groups for the awakening practice, living from presence. So you do the practice, then you can feel the presence and the presence starts running your life. So you're evolving, evolving, transforming, transforming. So I was told that we're at a stage now where we don't need to do groups. And what we do is we do it on our own. And I've called this the Master's Path, because they taught me lots of shortcuts, how to get to the Ascendant Master's realm, this field of infinite love and pure knowingness. This is what you're awakening to. They are there waiting to help mankind, those souls. Not everybody's going to make it, I can assure you that, because of the nature, people don't believe it, you know, people don't, you talk to people, they don't want to know. But the few that do want to know, and if you're one of these, do this. You'll have to buy this book, that's the only thing you have to buy, and I suggest you get a hard copy, hardback. It's a hardback and a paperback. Get the hardback version, because this is a gem. It's packed, absolutely packed, with bullet to the point, direct teachings. Now, rules and regulations, religions love this. They tell you how to be, what you have to do to get to God. In this book, I was told by the Ascendant Masters, one rule or one divine code, how to live your life, for only for the spiritual seeker, not for the rest of mankind that's living from the personality. We need social laws to regulate them. But if you're a spiritual seeker, you'll only need one law, one rule to live your life by. That's in this book. Also, the Ascendant Masters told me how to connect with them, and I show you in this book how to do that. You do that and you go straight there and you'll be blissed out. You'll be blissed out. You'll instantly go there. You'll instantly start feeling divine love presence. It's incredible. All the answers are in this book. It also teaches you how to live and how to deal with your life. So it's a real shortcut. Fantastic. Anyway, I love you all very much, and I hope this has been helpful to you. Love you, love you, love you. Thank you, thank you, thank you.